Alright guys, so today is a very important lesson. Today I'm going to teach you how to squat. Now I have already in my previous reels and even my YouTube videos I've already explained how to squat, but today I'll be teaching you as well as demonstrating you right on the spot, right? So the first things first, you should know how to brace your core. Now core bracing is just like when you wear a belt, so your core becomes tight, right? But you have to be able to do it without the belt. So in order to practice that, do this with both of your hands and press tightly with these fingers. Press the core, your abdominal area, press it and then breathe into it, not from your chest, but breathe into your core like this. See my fingers, you see? So this region should be tight. All this region, your lower back and your abs combined, is called the core. So tip number one, you should be able to embrace your core properly in order to squat or deadlift, or basically for any lift. You should know how to embrace your core. Tip number two, now we come to the squat. First, you have to know how to take the position. See, a lot of people do this. First of all, this is not the position. You should be able to go full deep squat. As a human being, you should be able to go full deep, right? You should know how to squat as to grass. If you are unable to squat as to grass without any weight, then there is a problem in your body regarding your mobility and your overall functionality, right? And it's most probably your tight glutes or tight hamstrings, and maybe even the ankle mobility, right? So I've already explained how to improve ankle mobility in my YouTube videos and also in some of my reels, so please check them out. So before squatting you should first embrace your core and then look at my knees, right? Now they are in neutral position, but I have to turn them outside. You see what I did? Turn them outside. My knees moved outside. So what this creates is a little arch in my foot, making it a tripod. A tripod stance is 3 points, and it's actually one of the most strongest position if you want to squat properly. So by turning, do not turn your feet, just turn your knees outside, and it will automatically create an arc in your feet. So this is point number two. Point number one, embrace the core. Point number two, turn your knees. Now comes the squatting part. You should, if your core is embraced properly, you should be able to squat upright. You have to keep your upper body upright as much as possible. A lot of people do this. When they go down, their upper body just leans forward. This should not happen when you're squatting, right? You should be able to keep your body upright if you want to properly squat and emphasize your quads and hamstrings. If you lean forward while squatting, then you're putting yourself in danger, right? So now, doing all these 3 points combined, I'm going to show you how to squat. First, one, two, three. 3 point racking, 3 point setup system, right? Now, embrace the core, turn your knees outwards, and then squat. Keep your body upright. Your core should be embraced. My core is still tight even though I'm talking, right? And since my ankle mobility is good and my hip mobility is good, I'm able to squat full ass to grass, right? So you should be able to do this without the weights also and with the weights also. If you are unable to do full ass to grass, this is known as ass to grass squat. If you are unable to do ATG squat, then there's something wrong with your mobility. So first you should work on your mobility and then you should move on to squatting practice, right? So your core is embraced, my body is upright, I'm looking up, never look down, I'm always looking up. And one more thing, that my elbows
are in alignment of my upper body. Some people do this, some people do this. This should not happen, right? Your elbows, your arms should be in alignment with your upper body, and then you squat up. So this is how you squat.